Hey guys, my name is Jess. It is the 14th of March today and you're watching GameSpot News. Here's the good stuff. Blizzard has revealed the first 8 new cards coming within Hearthstone's 3rd expansion, Whispers of the Old Gods. The new cards include corrupted versions of classic cards such as Loot Hoarder and Doomsayer. And the corrupted Doomsayer is a uniquely part-time 7/7 for 5 mana. There is also the Eater of Secrets, a 4 mana 2/4 which destroys all secrets and gets buffed 1/1 for every secret destroyed. That one should be a big worry for Paladin secret decks. There are also 4 legendary cards being introduced to carry the theme of godly evils awakening from their slumber. One of which is K'thun, a 10 mana 6/6 with a unique battle cry that can be buffed before it's deployed. Whispers of the Old Gods is due out in late April or early May, and 134 new cards are expected to arrive with it. Bethesda has revealed a brand new trailer for Fallout 4's Automatron DLC and revealed a release date. The DLC will center on a character called The Mechanist, who has unleashed a horde of robots hell-bent on attacking everything in sight. You'll then hunt down robots and harvest their bits to build your own customizable robot buddy. Automatron will cost you $9.99 and will be released for PS4, Xbox One, and PC on March 22. The DLC also introduces new armor, abilities, and weapons. Automatron will be followed up by the Wasteland Workshop and Far Harbor DLC packs, releasing in April and May respectively. You can get access to all 3 through the Fallout 4 DLC pass, which recently increased in price to $50. Finally, Microsoft is saying what any of us who've had to choose between consoles or friendship groups have wanted to hear today, in that they want PS4 and Xbox One to connect together online. Microsoft has said they will natively support cross-platform play between Xbox One, Windows 10, and other, quote, online multiplayer networks. This opens up the Xbox Live platform so it can accommodate players on Sony's PlayStation Network, among others. Chris Charla, director of ID at Xbox, made the announcement on Xbox.com. He explained, "It's up to game developers to support this feature," adding that players will always have the option of choosing to play only with other Xbox Live players. The first game to support the functionality will be Psyonix's Rocket League, which will let Xbox One and PC players matchmake against each other. Microsoft have extended an invitation for other networks to participate as well. The PS4 has previously had matchmaking capabilities with PCs, with games like Portal 2, Street Fighter 5, and Rocket League. Let me know down in that comment section how you feel about cross-platform play, and be sure to head to GameSpot where we've got stories on Titanfall coming to Origin Access and The Division server maintenance. That's everything I have for you today. As always, let me know what mattered to you, and I will see you again tomorrow.